having just walked up through what is a beautiful bushwalk here, and just down below here, scrambling up through a hole in the rocks and up into this area just here, which is getting pretty near, pretty close to the top of the hill here, we have what's known as the Gosford Glyphs. And here they are in here, so we'll have a closer look at them. Actually, before we have a closer look at the glyphs, I just popped up the hill here, and just looking at this rock formation just here, it's quite an interesting rock formation, and I just want to show you this because we'll just now go across over here and have another look at another interesting rock formation that there have been speculations as to what this rock formation could be used for, or that it was created, but I just noticed that there are other interesting rock formations around, so this is perhaps a natural formation here, dare I say it. I didn't really come up here to get into a debate about the glyphs and other things people have said about the area. I'm not really here, I don't really intend to make too much of a judgment, so we'll just head back down to the glyphs. Again, here we can see that interesting formation, and it definitely is a, you know, quite an interesting formation in the rock there. But if we look just down here, again we have another one of these interesting formations in the rock there, sort of scooped up. So we'll keep on heading down. Yet again through here we have some more interesting rock formations on this larger rock scape here, and as we move along, this is just up above the glyphs still, there's some rock carving through here, the old circles. These are deeper than the glyphs, and possibly put here by someone else. Might be Aboriginal, maybe not, I'm not sure. One thing I can say, another one there, just bits and pieces along the way here. So the glyphs would be just over this direction here, we're still heading down. One thing I can say for sure is that that Sean was here, and that Sean's probably a bit of a dickhead for riding in the rocks up around here, but so we'll keep heading towards the glyphs. So I'm just about to head down here and then just down through here and back towards the glyphs, which are just down in there. There's a bit of a hole down through here. There's a cavity that someone's purposely filled it in here, but it goes into a little bit of a cavern down through here, and other people have taken photographs of it. It's said to be a tomb of some sort by some people, but so we'll just have a look back down here at the glyphs. Just my own observations here. I just noticed that with the glyphs, some of them are much, the imprint into the rock is much shallower, particularly these ones here, compared with other ones. The one of Anubis here is much shallower. And also, this one looks like it's been put in at another time, perhaps by a different person. It doesn't look very sophisticated to me. It looks different. Through here there are lots of cases where it just doesn't sort of line, it's not very symmetrical. You can see there's a lack of sort of symmetry here. Perhaps I expect more from Egyptian artists. Up here you have the lines coming down and they don't sort of carry right down. It just looks, again, unsophisticated. In this cross just here, you can see another mark, as if there was, and then they decided to make another mark there. In this glyph here, you can just see the lack of artistry in there. That's apparent to me from my observations. Most importantly, Josephine, what's your take on these hieroglyphs in Gosford?